day is something like 8.
Right.
Yeah.
That's still good, though, because, I mean, Jose's going to be number 2 probably again.
Jose's been pretty, like, he's been doing work. He also has been dropping a lot, so.
Yeah.
Okay, we're just going to get right into it.
The one thing that I'd like to see from Loyal is I'd like to see more up throws in general with his Game & Watch. He does down throws a lot, and I feel like it's not as guaranteed.
Yeah, it's kind of like, why would you do that? Even if you get the punish, it's like, you can get an equally big punish off of the up throw, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Because, like, he really loves that down smash, though, you know?
Yeah, he literally just throws him down and charges it.
Okay, down throw up air.
Nice.
Nice.
Kills pretty early.
Yeah. This stage, plus the fact that Game & Watch is super light.
Yeah.
I think we wasted our double jump. Oh, no, we didn't. Nice.
So, he's still living.
Oh.
I like Jose's footsie game near the ledge. He kind of makes it hard to
ooh,
figure
wow,
out what
nice.
He's doing.
Yeah, Jose has such tricky movement with the added double jump cancels and stuff. Mm-hmm. My least favorite thing that he does to me is like when I'm shielding and he keeps carving in like diagonally with back airs and I try to shield grab one and I just eat
and
the next back
air. And then
you
eat the next one, yeah.
Yeah. Oh dude, my god!
Okay, that's something that I've noticed just in the last probably 3 weeks that Jose has like tripled the use of his forward smash.
Dude, it's so good.
He was, but he would never use it. And now I feel like his just like call outs that he has on players is like, yo, you're going to roll here, you're going to stay here, you're going to approach in here, and it's just like he's been capitalizing a lot off of that.
That's cool. It's good that he's been doing reads with that, because I know that like Jose has been reading players' rolls and stuff for a while.
Yeah.
He will down tilt you a million times and then dash because he knows that you're going to roll back.
Yeah.
So it's cool to see that he's doing a similar idea with a move that kills instead of just getting a grab.
Right.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Wasn't that sick how he like avoided the down tilt there? That's hard. That move's so good. Yo, he stood still, waited for the roll, but the animation for Game & Watch is a little weird looking, so I guess he just misspaced it. Jab reset. Oh, nice.
Nice. That was that just back air carving you were talking about earlier.
Oh, yeah. That guy knows how to carve a slice.
Surf's up, dude.
Let's see if Loyal can take him down to the last stock without taking too much percent.
I mean, he's like a down tilt away from having a follow-up.
That's true. Oh, but Jose.
Oh, double up air.
He does so much damage.
Waits for him. Gets a grab. Oh, almost gets a grab. I like that mix-up. He did the double dare last time, so then this time, or the double back air last time, so this time when he bared, he just ran in and got the fair.
Oh. Yeah. Oh! Gave him so much height. Oh, did he slide off? Oh, no, I think he probably didn't come back.
Wow.
Oh, my God. Nine. I'm getting flashbacks of the Lucky set.
Right. I know you're winning, Lucky, but I'm sorry to do this to you.
But did you remember that I get a free kill?
Yeah, right.
Like it's like it's like a punch card.
I was just thinking it's the middle square in bingo. It's just like you have this just to start out.
Yeah, pretty much.
Loyal's down 2-5 against Jose this season.
Oh, I guess the third win at Land Diego was last
season. Yeah, which makes sense. There's your number, though, 5.
Oh, yeah. I think Jose 5 is one of my favorite
right?
my favorite Jose-related things.
Yeah, my little brother forgot his name was Jose, and he's like, how's your – and I call him Jose 5 just as, like, a joke.
Yeah.
And my brother was like, yo, how's Juan 5?
Juan 5.
I was like, dude, wrong one. Dude, Game & Watch swinging right out the gate.
Yeah. Oh!
I feel like Loyal's been a little preemptive in his aerial options.
Yeah,
when Jose in general as a player is the one to gimp or to bait those things out.
Yeah, exactly.
And you know just punish.
Jose like throws out moves from a safe distance.
Yeah. Boop. At least he's up throwing.
Nice nair.
You know, Loyal. At least he's up throwing right now.
That's true. Like, the thing, though, is I don't think Loyal's getting that many grabs because he's opting to down tilt instead, you know?
Yeah.
Which is, you know, that's also a valid choice. Oh, catches him with a backhammer. Up throw, up air, back air.
Turtle.
Nice!
Oh, my
God!
That was
God.
Such a good runoff. Now,
match
chair.
Oh, no.
I was thinking the chair.
Anything. Like, not I mean, wa- not, I was not thinking walk into the move.
That's the last thing I wanted.
Yeah, it's like, now walk into the move.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah, right. Like, yeah, I was thinking the chair just because it's got a pretty good disjoint.
Oh, yeah, it's the easiest move in the game.
Yeah.
Like,
and it probably would have traded without him, or at least beat it without him getting his double jump back. Mm-hmm. Nice forward tilt. I always like to see the finesse moves like that used.
Yeah, it's kind of like this is like the only thing. Oh, my God.
Oh,
oh
wow.
But Game & Watch has so much vertical reach. That was like instant. Down air, instant jump back air to catch the out of shield. Interesting.
Oh! Hey, bada bada.
Little slugger.
And he taunts just for good measure. I mean, he's up 1-0 right now.
It's heading, like,
in, heading into the 2-0.
Oh, loyal tries, but you can't do that. You can't be doing that when you're. Look at Loyal is so eager to hit him with that fair.
He's just reaching right now, dude.
I mean, it's working for the moment, you know.
Oh,
the trade.
Good trade. I'd like a little bit more patience when it comes to when you get him up. It's like if you're not gonna reach him because the guy's three character lengths above you,
yeah.
Don't throw out the fair.
Yeah,
get down
much,
to the
right?
ground.
Oh, but look. I know. Look at the combo. Oh. By the way, Loyal's next number is an even number, so it's
definitely
not a 9. I'm just going to let you all know because we remember what happened last time.
Is he going to burn it? Oh, I thought he was just going to burn it right there.
Oh, is that?
Burn it. No burn.
Matchstick.
Down. Oh.
Yo, let's go.
You called it, dude. I was thinking down tilt.
Oh. Down tilt might have been better, but matchstick helped because of just like he popped above the leg.
Yeah. Well, that's what I was thinking. I was thinking Jose
He's
was going to
good
be
at sweet
closer,
spotting sometimes.
Yeah.
Game 3. I thought that I counted Loyal out for sure.
Yeah, I was sitting there saying he's heading into a 2-0.
Yeah.
Because he was up 3-1.
I know. What a comeback. No 9 required. This ain't no lucky set.
Right?
It's funny how, like, luck is what let him be lucky.
The irony.
Yeah.
You're not like, so lucky.
It's like, are you the lucky one?
Right.
Or was it me?
Jose playing much more aggressive. Right now.
Dude, when Jose is like carving like so low to the ground with all of his moves, it looks like a little like a Mexican jumping bean or something.
Oh man.
Up air? Yeah.
That's it. That's all she wrote, dude.
Pretty much. I feel like Game & Watch is just like kind of bone when it gets down to it at that percentage.
Yeah. Nice dash tag. I like Jose's aerial drift. Just his awareness.
Ooh.
Wow, that's kind of weird. Just his awareness of where Loyal's going to be, which is pretty good.
Yeah, like, I don't know. Like, I feel like Jose doesn't miss space his aerials as often as a lot of other players do.
Yeah. Horrible DI on that.
Yeah.
He was probably trying to fade back.
He was trying to carve away, yeah. But he got hit by it.
Wipeout!
Nice. Down throw. Up air. Later.
Later.
Dude, this is like so easy.
Right?
I didn't realize it until right now, but like that's just like so guaranteed pretty much.
Yeah.
And it's like, what can Game & Watch do at that point? Like,
don't get grabbed. That's it.
Yeah. If he like, if he DI's back, it's just easier up air.
Right. That was a...
Oh.
Wow. That's swinging. Okay. That was a great...
I forgot what happened on the screen. There we go. Loyal's next hammer has a 1-in-4 chance of being a 9.
Nice trade. Dude, Loyal loves that get up attack.
The
hammer.
The hammer time?
Yeah.
Yeah. Nair.
Later. Loyal breathes out.
Oh no, you idiot. You didn't taunt cancel the second one. Now you just eat a little bit of damage.
I mean, Loyal had 1-3, and right now this is 2-2, high percent.
Yeah.
So this is not out of the realm of him being able to do anything. I think
down throw.
Back throw.
Oh, no, yeah. He's at too high of a percent.
Yeah,
now,
too high.
So he's outside of the danger zone. But he's inside of a different danger zone.
Yeah. I would like to see...
Bup, later.
I feel like he can bucket some of those PK fires, the, like, max range grounded ones.
Oh, true.
Not so much the aerial ones. Up air.
Oh, nice.
Up air.
Back
turtle.
Air. Oh, my God, that down air.
Oh, I thought the bacon was going to get him.
I knew
oh,
it.
Oh, yeah. And he, that almost killed.
Yeah. I was all like, because you know that's what Loyal does, right? Is that he loves a down throw more often when it's like high pressure towards the end of a set.
Yeah. It's just high risk, high reward.
Yeah, because he needs that reward. He needs it bad.
Straight out getting him with the fair. Nice. Whoa. That was so good.
Cuts out so that he doesn't get hit by the forwarder. Oh my god.
Oh, that's so scary. Jose doesn't have a double jump. Gets the grab up air. Misses the turtle. Gets a re-grab.
Oh my god. Remember, he has a 1-in-4 chance of getting a 9. I don't know if we're going to see it, but this is last stock game 3.
See, this is where I would like to see more buckets.
Oh, good
wow,
mash.
Wow, that mash, dude. You can hear that thing from around the world. A horrible
dash tag.
That,
no,
oh,
bad DI.
Bad DI.
Oh, Jose advances the winner semis, and Cameron is crushed.
He's in there, and he's like, I had a 1-in-4 chance of getting 9. Like, this is my time to shine.
Don't make fun of Mickey.
Hey, man, at least he's still in.
What, are you out?
I DQ'd myself after losing to Burnt Sox.
Oh, I see.
I got like 3 hours of sleep last night. Dojo got me at, I had to wake up at 7:30.
If you had to wake up at 7:30, why'd you not sleep earlier?
I couldn't sleep, and some kid who, it was going to be his first tournament here today,
uh-huh,
he texted me and woke me up at 1:30 in the morning, and I couldn't get back to sleep.
Oh,
so,
buddy.
No.
If you want to switch with me? All right. Well, Nick's going to hop on for all you.
I just got to warn you, I need to be carried in commentary because I'm pretty bad.